गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल ऑफ यू। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द प्रैक्टिकल ऑफ नॉन कन्वेंशनल मशीनिंग। ओके, सो बिफोर गोइंग टू द प्रैक्टिकल पॉइंट, फर्स्टली आई वुड लाइक टू टेल द व्हाट इज द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ आवर प्रैक्टिकल्स और द थर्मोर। ओके, सो फॉर दैट पर्पज आई हैव हियर शेयर्ड द सिलेबस ऑफ यूनिवर्सिटी फॉर आवर सब्जेक्ट। ओके, सो यू कैन सी, so as per the syllabus of our university, okay, for our subject, okay, that is professional elective 4 non conventional machining, we have the in semester exam 70 marks, then in semester exam that is IS 30 marks, and ICA internal continuous assessment, so in call we are calling it as a thermo, so it having 25 marks, and for oral exam university oral external oral exam we have the 25 marks. Okay, correct. So total 150 marks are there. Now as we know that for the theory exam or for theory we have the six chapters, six units. Okay, out of that we have already completed three, and fourth one is going on. Out of that again only two processes are remaining from chapter number this four, that is electrochemical machining and grinding. Okay, that we are going to see in the next lecture. Okay, and this fifth one and sixth one we are going to see in the next week. So total six units are there. Okay, for our we have to write total eight. We have write total 8 assignments. Okay, you can see as levels we have the 8 assignments. Now in that 8 assignments we have the two categories. One is the assignment we have to write minimum 6 assignments based on above 6 topic. That means it clearly stated that the per chapter we have to write one assignment. Okay, so as we are undergoing this COVID-19 situation, so pandemic situation, so it is not possible to write all the assignment, okay, to you. So here itself I will clear that as a requirement of or as a part of the term work, just 2 pages, okay, per assignment you have to write. Okay, and that 2 pages you have to per assignment, that means 6 assignment into 2 pages, that is 12. Okay, duni side not a single side, so total 12 pages you have to write as a requirement of this term work. Saha assignment manje pratyek assignment che don pages. Okay, mag te don question astel kiwa teen question astel. Okay, it is not compulsory to write 3 questions or 2 questions, it's depend on two or three. Okay, per unit kiwa per chapter don pages tumhala as a assignment manun lihav lagel. Okay, he zala kay pratyek assignment sa प्रत्येक चैप्टर एक असाइनमेंट, दैट इज फोर सिक्स असाइनमेंट, एंड प्लस यू हैव टू राइट टू पेजेस, दैट इज 4 पेजेस. ओके, एज अ टू केस स्टडीज, एडिशनल टू केस स्टडीज वी हैव टू गो, बिकॉज प्रत्येक चैप्टर चे एक एक असाइनमेंट म्हणजे 6 आणि 2 केस स्टडी, ते पण असाइनमेंट म्हणजे 8 केस स्टडी आपले होऊन जातील. आता 2 केस स्टडीज काय असणार, तर वी हैव टू राइट 2 केस स्टडीज के फॉर इफेक्ट ऑफ पॅरामीटर्स ऑन effect of parameters on material remove rate, that is MRR of non conventional machining process. Okay, so to write this case studies for effect of material remove rate, what you have to do, you have to study the research paper related to any two, once again I am repeating, you have to study any any research papers related to any two non-conventional machining processes. Okay, it may be your AJM or WJM, or it may be EDM or wire EDM, or is chemical machining or PCM or ELBM. Any two machining process you can take, and you can go through the maybe four research papers, and through that research study research paper you have to study that how the process parameter is affecting on material, that is performance. Okay, how your performance is going to affect by this process parameter, that you have to study, and that you have to write as a case study. Okay, प्रोसेस पॅरामीटरचा इफेक्ट मटेरियल रिमूव्हल रेटवर कसा होतोय ह्याचा स्टडी करायचा इन सिम्पल वर्ड्स. ओके, त्यासाठी तुम्ही कुठल्याही दोन केस स्टडी म्हणजे दोन मशीनिंग प्रोसेस घेऊ शकता आणि त्याच्या रिलेटेड एक चार चार रिसर्च पेपर तुम्ही सायन्स रिलेटेडचे घ्या, कुठलेही घ्या, नो प्रॉब्लेम. अँड यू हॅव टू राईट द केस स्टडीज. ओके, सो फॉर दॅट पर्पज ॲज पर द सिलेबस ओनली हियर दे हॅव रिटन दॅट यू कॅन रेफर जर्नल पेपर्स फ्रॉम द रिप्युटेड जर्नल प्रिपेअर विथ एस सी आय. दॅट मीन्स इट इज रिकमेंडेड दॅट or it is suggested that you can take reference reputed research papers or reputed journal papers. So for that purpose you can refer a science direct papers or IEEE paper or ASME papers. Okay, so I think you got the point that case study kai lecha, because already in the I think maybe in the third year first semester or second semester I think for the EMD 1 or 2 already you have gone for the case studies. Okay, likewise here also we have to go for the case studies, and here your major point should be that case studies a part kai paije aplyala process parameter cha effect material removal rate var kasa hotoy te fakt bagaycha, and that you have to study and that you have to write as a case study. Okay, so per case study you have to write the 2 pages. Okay, so 2 case studies means 4 pages, and plus 6 assignments of 2 pages means 12 plus 14, that is 16 pages write up you have to write for the our term or part. That's it. Okay, but it should include the 6 assignment and 2 case studies. Please, so this is syllabus for our term. Okay, and based on the your 6 units as well as this term of part you have to face for the oral exam. Okay, external oral exam. Okay, because we have the external oral exam of 25 marks. Now once again I am going to I would like to tell that for our subject, okay, non-conventional machining you can call or advanced machining process, please once again I am repeating that please go through this week advanced machining process book, okay, written by the our author that VK Jain, Vijay Jain. Okay, it is a very good book. Already a soft copy or ebook of this advanced machining process already I have shared with you. Okay, in the study material. Okay, again you can refer this non conventional machining by PK Mishra book, that is also very good. Again this manufacturing science, okay, so some part of our syllabus it comes under this book also. Okay, manufacturing science by Amitabh Ghosh and this, okay, Malik. Then again a PC Sharma book by book, that is this modern machining process, that is also very good. Again that if you search on Google, that is non traditional machining process by Gary Vendick, you will get that book also, that is also good. Again and again if you want to go for the how this advanced machining process introduced in our in a syllabus or in research, so for that purpose also this MacJove, okay, this advanced machining, that is also a very old book. Okay, because this VK Jain he has referred this advanced methods of machining, because it's a reference he has given in this advanced machining book. Okay, again you can again I have given the ebook of this advanced machining process by Hassan Ilufi. Okay, it's a ebook copy I have shared in the study book. Okay, and if anybody want to go for the in detail about this advanced machining process, okay, if you have interest, then you can go for the it's a micro machining also. So for that purpose also you get the ebook of this introduction to micro machining, okay, by again VK Jain. Okay, that is also very good. Okay, so these are the references for our subject. Okay, now come to the one more point, that is now here just I have told that you have to write the assignment of 2 or 3 questions based on the each and every unit. Okay, so just for a sample purpose here I have taken some sample question for each and every assignment. Okay, that I will show here. Okay, so now whatever the requirement of institute as an assignment, that part is different. Whatever I am telling here now, so that is the, these are the assignment, that is requirement of Turbo. Okay. So I will share that also. Wait. Now you can see. Okay, so in assignment one number one, okay, which is based on the your unit number one, you can write the three, you can write these three three questions. Okay, very simple questions I have given. Okay, in two question in two pages you have to write this three questions. Okay, if you have the blank pages, then you can write more also, no problem, but at least a minimum two pages it is a requirement from my side. Okay, so you can see the question number one from the assignment number one, that is I have given that why do we need a advanced machining process. So answer of this question you have to write. Okay, very simple question I have given. Okay, because already the our this NCM subject I have started with this question only. Okay, one lecture I have spent on this point. Why do we need advanced machining process? And these questions I have taken from that advanced machining processes by VK Jain book. Okay, in that book also you will get the answer of this question. Okay, then the second question based on the unit number one is that classify the modern machining processes, that means classification of non-conventional or classification of advanced machining process, that you have to write this classification on the base of type, based on basis of type of energy employed, that you have to write. Okay, that means classification. And also you have to state that what is the mechanism of material removal, how the that transformer, what will be the transformer medium for your material removal, and which energy sources are used. Okay, so about that you have to write the question number two. Okay, again the answer you will get in that book. Okay, very easy, because already we have studied this one. Okay, then the third one question. Okay, now this is I've given practical oriented question. Okay, now see the statement of the this question is I have written that how will you decide to recommend a specific advanced machining process. Okay, how will you decide to recommend specific advanced machining process for? Okay, the situation I have given, and you with respect to that situation you have to suggest or you have to justify that also advanced machining process. Okay, so situation number one is that cutting a glass plate into two pieces. Okay, you have to cut glass plate into two pieces. Now for cutting of this glass plate, which advanced machining process would you like to recommend? Okay, and why you want to recommend? Okay, that means just because for example if I will give answer like that, you can use abrasive jet machining. Okay, so my question, next question will be why. So why means the justification, why AJM is best suitable for cutting a glass plate. It's that answer you have to write. Okay, so here your justification is required. Then the second number situation I have given that making a hole in a mild steel workpiece. Okay, workpiece is there and its material is mild steel, and we have to drill a hole. So for making that hole in that mild steel plate, which advanced machining process you will recommend, and its a justification you have to write. Okay, so here two situations I have given, and it's a justification you have to write as an assignment. Okay, so very very simple three questions I have given as an assignment. Okay, if you read the first chapter in from advanced machining process book, then you will get the easily the answer of this all three questions. Okay, so this is assignment number one. Then let us move for the assignment number two. Okay, as we know that our chapter already we have covered that mechanism of energy based non-conventional machine processes. Now in that I have given the four questions. Out of that four questions, you can write three questions, no problem for you. Okay, in that simple questions I have given, that means the first question is that draw a schematic diagram of AGM system, that is draw a schematic diagram of abrasive jet system and label it. Okay, so abrasive jet machine is a diagram card, and there's a knowledge. Then again situational based or practical oriented question here I have written that comment on, okay, you have to comment on abrasive jet machining is not recommended to machine ductile method. Okay, comment means what? You have to write the justification, okay, or you have to write the answer of why question. Why means what? Why advanced machining why abrasive jet machining is not recommended to machine ductile material. Okay, it's a justification you have to write. Okay, again I will give cue or hint that the answer of this question you will get in that non-traditional machining processes book by Gary Bindict. Okay, if you search on the Google then ebook of Gary Bindict, you will get in that book you will get the answer of this question. Okay, again we have the third question. Again it is practical oriented. Okay, if you you have studied this advanced machining process, then definitely the its answer you will get. Okay, so you have to take the back in the subject. Cutting tool never dulls or breaks in water jet machining. Why cutting tool never dulls or breaks in advanced in water jet machining? It's an explanation you have to write. Okay, that is third question. And one more here question I have given. Okay, so you can along with me you can read the question. So you have to write the answer of following question in brief you have to write. So here again I have given the situation that, okay, you can read. I will read some parts in situation. I have given some parts in aerospace industry are made up of asbestos material. Next, because of high level of asbestos in air, okay, which is harmful to the health of worker. Okay, so because of high level of asbestos in the air at cutting station, okay, at cutting station is at the center of the that machining. Okay, the material asbestos is going to cut at that center. So there OSHA, that means the for you can take OSHA name as a manager, okay, or owner of that company. So OSHA shut down that company, and the name here I'll written that Lockheed Georgia companies. Okay, so OSHA sit down that company in the cutting operation section. Okay, yeah, where that asbestos is cutting now, so that section he has closed. Why he has closed? Because of high level of asbestos in the air. Okay, so if you as in charge of that section, so you as in charge of that section are asked to suggest two suitable advanced machining techniques, to suggest two suitable advanced machining technique so that work can resumed in that section. Work can be resumed in that section. Asbestos cut karayla kutla don suitable advanced machining technique astil te tumhala sangayche jene karun tita asbestos प्रमाण एयर मधले कमी झालं पाहिजे. सो यू हॅव टू थिंक ऑन दिस सिच्युएशन अँड देन यू हॅव टू राईट द जस्टिफिकेशन ऑफ दॅट क्वेश्चन. ओके, सो दॅट इज एक्सपेक्टेड इन दिस क्वेश्चन. सो दिस इज सिच्युएशन नंबर वन. ओके, सो लाईक वॉज अ सेकंड सिच्युएशन आय हॅव गिवन दॅट कंपोजिट प्लेट्स आर टू बी कट डाऊन इन टू स्मॉलर पीसेस ऑन ए लार्ज स्केल. ओके, वी हॅव द वर्क पीस विच इज मेड अप ऑफ द कंपोजिट प्लेट and that composite plate we have to cut down into smaller pieces again into in a large scale. Okay, and there good finish is required. Okay, that means the surface finish should be good. So which process or which processes will you recommend? So that is a situation number 2. You have again you have to write the justification or you have to write a comment on this. Okay, you have to recommend that. So that is a
This is assignment number 2. Okay. So likewise, assignment number 3 I have given. Again, the assignment number 3 is based on the your unit number 3, that is electric energy based non-conventional machine process, that is EDM or EDM and wire cut EDM. Okay. So here also I have given the simple question. That means the first one is with the help of neat sketch, just to explain the mechanism of removal of the material in EDM. Okay. EDM's mechanism lets removal of the material. Okay, simple. Then in second question, you have to write the working principle of wire cut EDM, and you have to explain why that stratified wire, how that stratified wire works. Okay, so both points I have already covered in my lecture. Then that third question you have to write, that illustrate the effect of following parameters or MRR during EDM. Okay, for EDM process, how following process parameters are effect on material removal rate, that you have to explain. And here they have written the process parameter, that is resistance, then current density, pulse energy and capacitance. Okay, again here for this question you can refer the advanced machining processes by VKJ. Again, the fourth question here again I have given. Okay, here you have to write the short note about the EDM technology, wire cut EDM technology, and in that you have to write the explanation about the dielectric system, wire drive system and position system. Already this point also I have covered. Okay, then okay, you can just read this question within 1 hour. I will come back. You can read this question. Okay, those students who came late, please write down your roll number in the chat box. Okay, otherwise what happened, when I am taking attendance from that time,
your roll number is not appearing in that chat box. Okay, due to that, maybe sometime your attendance may mark as absent. Okay, those who have came late. Okay, so I was talking about this this assignment number 4. Okay, again now this chapter we have only two processes we have covered, that is chemical based. Okay, so you know, to chemical energy based, that we are going to talk tomorrow onwards. Again, based on this unit number 4, we have to write the 4 question, and so 4 question I have written here. That is again, it's a word copy or maybe PDF copy. I will share in the your WhatsApp group. Okay, so here again I have given that why surface finish obtained in case of chemistry of alloy is poor. Okay, it's a explanation you have read. Okay, see, in theory part I am covering all points. Okay, and here as the assignment, okay, I am giving the situational or practical oriented questions, because here I have given the questions like that. You have, firstly, how to go through the theory in detail, and then you will be able to write the answer of this question. Okay, for that purpose I have given here some difficult questions. Okay, that is my intentionally I have given that. Okay, not I have not given the straightforward questions. Okay, so the first question for assignment 4 is that why a surface finish obtained in case of chemistry of alloys, okay, is poor. It's a justification or it's a explanation you have to write. Then you have to explain the steps with the help of flow diagram of PCM. Okay, PCM process you have to explain. Okay, now this process already today I have covered. Then related to the ECG, ECM, electrochemical machining, tomorrow I am going to talk. So working principle and what is equipments used or the setup, what is its application and the process capability or process characteristic, that tomorrow I am going to cover. So it is related to that. Here I have given the question number 3. Okay, and related to electrochemical grinding I have given the 4th question. So likewise, this is assignment number 4. Now what will be the questions of the assignment number 5 and 6, that I'm going to cover in the next practical. Okay, no problem. Only two or three questions I will give about the unit number 4, so unit number 5 and 6. Okay, that's simple. So the here I have covered the four assignments. Okay, so this document I will share in the assignment that in your WhatsApp group. Again, as during that PCM lecture already I mentioned that we have the facility of PCM, so we will conduct one practical, okay, actual practical of PCM machining. Okay, so next time or next week I will show the whole process, actual process of PCM. Okay, okay, from our that PCM lab. Okay, so this is a practical questions. Okay, now give me 1 minute. I will search is any video is available regarding chemical machining, that I will just see. Again, here once I again I would love to tell that if any point is missing, if you have missed any point, then you can visit that Let's Learn and Grow Together YouTube channel at YouTube. Okay, and you can see my lecture also. Okay, all lectures are available. Let's just travel. So with the help of this video, you can see how the chemical etching process is carried out. Whatever steps I have explained, so all steps they are doing. Okay, this is actual industry video. And this is a final product. Okay, you can see. Okay, so I was talking about my that YouTube lectures. Okay, you can see on YouTube all lectures are available. Okay, more than 1,000 views already available. Okay, so this is about the today's practical. So with this, for this practical, we'll stop here for today's this practical. Okay, in next practical, or maybe in within 2 days, I will show the practical exposure of that PCM lab. Okay. So thank you very much. Now, if anybody has not given an attendance, you can write down your attendance in chat box. Otherwise, I request all of you, please write down your attendance. Yeah, please give your attendance. Okay, those who have given already attendance, they have also need to write attendance.